should be an interesting matchup between the Los Angeles Rams and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. With that, let's head over to Raymond James Stadium in Tampa for the call of this one. We bring in our broadcast team, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thanks. CA Sports coverage of the NFL has us on the west coast of the Sunshine State. Downtown Tampa's the spot, Raymond James Stadium. With the echoes of cannon blast still ringing in our ears from the north end zone, the Bucs were introduced a moment ago, and they are all set as their guys will do battle with the Los Angeles Rams. Happy to be on hand. I'm Brandon Gunn with Charles Davis. And before we kick, partner, your keys to the game, please.
Well, my keys are on the defensive side of the ball for both teams. And the big one, making sure you avoid giving up the big play. These safeties are going to get tested all game long. Their job, keep the ball in front of them, tackle people, make them run extra plays in order to try and score.
Here's the punter, Bradley Pinion, on to get us started. And off we go from Tampa. This is fielded at the goal line. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. So out come the Rams now for their first possession. They'll be led out by their quarterback, the guy out of California, the former Cal Bear, Jared Goff.
While in college, quarterback teams that improved their win total from 1 his freshman year, to 5 his sophomore year, to 8 his junior year. Love that type of improvement. Love that type of diligence.
Here's the first carry now for Todd Gurley. He'll wind up getting a yard on the game's first play. It's second down. The headshots here are the offensive unit. And what about Brandon Cooks?
If he's not a 1,000-yard receiver every year he's healthy in the league, I'll be surprised. Came out of college wanting to be a pro, studied all the best receivers in the NFL before he even got to the league.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Goff turns and gives to Gurley. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it. The starting 11 defensively for Tampa Bay.
It's easy to go back to the time Ndamukong Suh entered the NFL, and he was an absolute force right from the beginning. But it's been fun to watch his career progress, and I'm starting to see a little more finesse in his game, although I'm not sure he'd like me to describe it that way. But you see the agility, you see the movement, and of course, he can bull rush when he needs to get to the quarterback.
An early tough test on the opening drive. This is 3rd and 8. Out of the gun, gone. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
And third down is a key down in any game you play. And third down defense, something we've got to watch in this one. Got to be effective on the passing downs. That's a pretty good first step right there.
So on fourth down, here's Johnny Hecker to punt it away. Back deep, Jadon Mickens. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. And that one hits at the 7, but bounds into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. So here are the Bucs now to take over for the first time. And they're led out by a guy who's done just about everything you could ever imagine to do in this league, the great Tom Brady.
It's been a lot of fun watching him develop in his career, but that will to win, he's had that probably since birth, and it transmits itself throughout his entire ball club. Watching him play, it can be an absolute joy unless you're on the other team.
Wait, that 53?
Yeah, right there, 54, Mike.
We own him.
Now the first carry for Ronald Jones. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. On your screen now, here are the offensive starters. At wideout, Antonio Brown is certainly someone that the defense always has to account for.
Without a doubt, a true number one receiver, it doesn't matter to him how defenses want to cover him. He sees it as a challenge and knows how to defeat him.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Shotgun now for Brady. This is caught by Antonio Brown. And he'll be out of bounds at the 25-yard line. That catch good for five. It's third down. The defense here for the Rams.
I got a kick out of talking last year with Aaron Donald about how when he came out of college, many NFL teams thought he might be undersized to play defensive tackle. Instead, he's been a perennial all-pro, Pro Bowl player since day one, and offenses are still searching for ways to block him and keep him from disrupting their offense.
The last play on the completion got him half of what they needed. Now here's a tough third and five. Working from the gun, it's Brady. And that is incomplete. So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
So on now is the Clemson man, Bradley Pinion, to punt this one away. JoJo Natson back deep for the Rams. This is taken at the 18. That's going to go in the books as a 55-yard punt. Well done. And the Rams will go on offense here with a first and 10. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And on the first drive, three and out. And I know that these are professional athletes, but I would imagine sometimes you get the nerves at the beginning of a game still, don't you?
Those don't ever go away. And typically what I've heard from guys and what I remember from playing, if you don't have nerves at the start of a game, it's not going to be a great day for you. You're not really ready to play. So finding a way to harness those nerves and not let them affect you in a negative way, that's what all the guys are looking for.
They'll start out on the ground with Gurley. Only a couple there as he'll be brought down about the 28.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
Throwing on second and 8, Goff. The ball comes out, and it's picked up by the Buccaneers. So the defense there, opportunistic.
It's nice to give them credit, isn't it? Because so many times it's more a matter of what the offensive guy didn't do. Didn't secure the ball, didn't cover up. In this case, let's just give credit to where it belongs. Knocked it free, made a big play.
And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And a three and out on that first drive. We'll see if they can do better here.
They should have a better opportunity because the nerves should be settled now. That first series, everybody goes out there, a little extra emotion. So now they get a chance to go back out and say, okay, now we're into the game. Let's go play and play as best we can.
You almost get a mulligan then on that first drive?
Sometimes it absolutely serves that way. You get a second opportunity. Nothing big happened. But then again, you didn't commit any mistakes either. Off you go.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And this is a unit that, to be frank, doesn't look like they've woken up yet. I mean, a punt and a turnover on their first two drives.
And I think the game's starting to take shape a little bit now. And I'm going to take it to the basketball world. When you're having trouble scoring or moving the ball in basketball, what do? get it to their best player, right? Find a matchup, create it, exploit it, and try and move the football. It is hard in zone coverage to stop a curl route because when they see it, they just try and find the open spot and sit down.
Yeah, we always talk about finding the soft spot in the zone. What's the key to doing that? How do you do it?
You have to read what the coverage is. Is it two deep? Is it three deep? Because then you know where the linebackers are going to drop, what spots on the field they naturally get to, and you find that open space, and then you're in sync with your quarterback. He should be reading the exact same thing, and they put the ball right on you.
Now Gurley. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield.
That's a tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that. Got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
Throwing on second and 14, Goff, and his throw here is incomplete. Brandon Cooks, the receiver he was going after, but now it'll be third down. Just a little beyond the reach there of his receiver. That's probably one he wishes he had back.
He wishes it had been 7-on-7 in practice, or maybe even routes versus air, because that's a completion he makes, what, 9.9 times out of 10? Just missed that one.
Third and long, it's Goff. Well, the two men come together, and it's incomplete. Excellent work defensively, brings up fourth down.
You hear the calls for a penalty, but I just don't think so. I think in this situation, the defender was making sure his guy couldn't hold on to the football. So I don't see anything to warrant the flag.
No, I'm with you. There was contact, but I'm happy they kept that flag in the back pocket. Here's Johnny Hecker now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And that one hits a little too close to the goal line, and it continues into the end zone for a touchback. Here comes the Tampa Bay offense now heading back out onto the field. And the last drive, their first drive, three and out. What changes here, if anything?
I think it's making sure the guys that you trust the most with the ball, the biggest playmakers you have, that they touch it on this possession to try and get things moving.
So get it to the horses.
Without a doubt. They're the ones that typically end up in the end zone.
Right that flag, 20.
Mike 58, right there.
Mike 28.
They'll start the drive with a carry by Jones. He'll get about three as he's taken down at the 23. A minimal gain as we tick down inside of a minute remaining in the opening quarter.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
On second and 7, Brady. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter, he's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series, they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall.
It's a foot race. He's at the 40. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. As his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. Well, he only needed 2 yards. It was third and 2, but he found a way to make the Red Sea part.
And remember, it's third and 2. In the NFL, that's not automatically a running down. Most of the time, it's a passing play. So in this case, now they're probably loosened up just a little bit, thinking pass. They hit him with the run, and boy, did they hit him big. Is he still going? I mean, Michael, you called the touchdown, right?
Yeah, I did. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. So the drive there, they went 80 yards in 3 plays. And it's Ronald Jones that polishes it off with a touchdown run. Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. This is taken at the three. And he will be taken down here as the first quarter of play will come to an end. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. They'll be looking to match that touchdown from a moment ago. 7-0 is the score as they begin with a first down. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. Call it a loss of 2 on the play. And that'll make it 2nd and 12. A pass for negative yardage, obviously no good. Maybe he shouldn't have thrown it, or maybe he shouldn't have caught it.
I think we were seeing it at the same time, weren't we? Maybe you let that one go, right? Because you can see the lost yardage about to develop. But that goes against every instinct of a receiver. They're taught to catch everything. So it's really hard to be mad at him and yell at him for trying to make that play.
So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on 2nd and 12. Goff now to throw. They'll find Everett there, complete.
Illegal touching, offense.
So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. The Rams on 3rd down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd down and 12. From the gun, here's Goff. And time finally runs out. He can't get rid of the football, and he's taken down. Shaquille Barrett put that sack by his name in the stat sheet.
Brandon, if I'm an offensive coordinator and I see an all-out rush like that, I file it away because I'm going to use their aggressiveness against them as this game goes on. I'm going to hit them with a screen soon.
Here's Johnny Hecker now, standing just outside his own goal line. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. Here's Mickens to return. Officially, that'll be a 63-yard punt. Well done. And the Bucs will get ready to go on offense. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. Things progressing to plan so far. Their defense has been solid, and they've got themselves a 7-0 lead after the touchdown the last time they had the ball.
And this is no time to even think about, hey, are we going to milk the clock? Hey, are we just going to do ball control? This is the NFL. 7-0 leads, they don't last very long unless you continue to push the envelope on offense.
Wait, set, Alabama, 380. Watch the ship, watch the ship. Hey, 66.
They run it. It's Ogunbowale. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
The last run got a couple. Here's 2nd and 8.
Hey, second.
To throw is Brady. It's complete. It's Miller. The 3rd down.
That's a gain of 4. Brings up 3rd and 5.
The Rams go nickel here defensively on 3rd. From the gun, it's Brady. Got a man. It's Breshad Perriman. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. First time these two have hooked up this afternoon, and it's a 1st down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, You're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Brady now to throw. He's got his tight end on the corner route. It's complete. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
One of the advantages of zone defense, as I remember it, is being able to see the play develop in front of you. One of the disadvantages, when they find those levels where they can hit you with it, sometimes behind the corner and in front of the safety, it makes it tough to defend.
So from Rams territory now, it's first and 10 at the 39-yard line. On the counter, here's Jones. And that'll hurt the average a bit, as this time they're able to get him behind the line. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. Brady's throw there complete, and he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. Seems as if the passing attack starting to heat up a little bit here in the second quarter.
You can sense and you can see the momentum, because now they're reading their patterns downfield, they're understanding the coverages, and they're finding the open holes in the defense.
Brady going to try and throw on third down, and this is going to be incomplete.
Perhaps they overthought this one a little bit. They've been running it real well on this drive, and it was third and short, okay? They decided to throw the football incomplete. Yeah, they might have thought just a little bit too hard about that play selection.
So on fourth down, on comes the Buccaneer kicker, Matt Gay. From the right hash, it's a 46-yard attempt. And his kick is absolutely perfect. And the lead moves to 10-0. So chalk that down as an 8-play drive capped with a field goal.
Yeah, as a friend of mine used to say, they were moving and grooving for a while, but they couldn't keep the momentum going enough to get a touchdown out of it.
The punter, Pinion, now to kick this one away. This is taken at his 4. They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. Todd Gurley and the Rams offense set to take over. They've given him some touches. They haven't had a lot of success on the ground. Do you maybe keep going to that well, or do you mix it up more?
I think you mix it up more, try and loosen things up. Get the defense to react to other people, other plays, but don't forget about it. That's your horse. You know, Secretariat lost twice in his career.
So educational. That's very true, kids. Look it up.
Black 20.
On first and 10, Goff. It's hauled in by Brandon Cooks. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. It'll be a first down for the Rams there on a pickup of 18. The Rams going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts, as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Goff now looking to throw. And Woods has it complete. As the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10.
It's our time.
A shotgun snap for Goff. He'll get this one to Kupp, complete. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. That one goes for 30 yards. For an offense that has not found the end zone yet, that's a big play.
There's the spark right there. The big play that they needed. Now they've got to go ahead and finish this drive and put this ball in the end zone.
The one running back is Gurley. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Now gone. And it's caught for a Rams touchdown by Brandon Cooks. A 5-yard touchdown catch as they are now on the board here in the first half. The way this one was going, you just got the sense they needed something before half. They've at least got something on the board now. Still trailing, but a good sign.
That takes me back to our preseason tour of NFL camps. You remember we talked with that one coach who said his emphasis this year was scoring in the last 2 minutes of a half, heading into the locker room. This hits it right there. Take that momentum, take that good feeling, and take it to the locker room, regroup, and start over. They got it here.
They did indeed. And a lot of football, full half to be played. They had to go to the monitor, get an extra look. That's what the technology is for, and this touchdown will count. Now Greg Zuerlein on for the extra point. And they're back within a field goal. It's 10-7 now. A drive there of just 4 plays. And the result for the Rams, a touchdown. Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. Back onto the field now comes the wideout Antonio Brown. Second quarter here, he has only one catch, but they have the lead. You got to think there's going to be more involved at some point.
That's what you would expect, but sometimes what defenses do to take away a player of his magnitude, it costs them in other areas. And right now, with them losing, they may have to change their focus, and maybe he will open up a little bit more as the game goes on.
So far, just the single catch. A little over 20 seconds remaining in the half as they'll line up here first and 10. And they'll indeed start on the ground to run that clock. And an anxious moment or two there, but they do get him down. It's a gain of 11, and the Bucs have a first down. We have hit halftime. Still two more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. It's in the game.
Okay, right, Brandon. Thanks very much. And welcome in, everyone, to this slimmed-down version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. This one's been as good as advertised. Just a field goal separating these two teams as they've already made their way back out of the locker room. So to bring you the story of the second half, let's get you right back out to Brandon Godden.
Thank you, sir. A field goal separates these two teams as we come back for this second half. The Bucks with a lead, and they'll get the football first as the second half is underway. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Out come the Buccaneers. They'll have it first to start in the third quarter. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had the ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
Now a man open down the middle of the field. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Here's a second and two now from the 33. Here's Jones, looking for a cutback lane, but nothing there as he's met at the line of scrimmage. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a third and two. And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively, six DBs in the game. A run with Ogunbowale. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10.
Yeah, let's get that ball, dude. Let's get that ball right here.
And that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
And plays like that are exactly what this defense needs here early in the second half to give it a little spark. I think their halftime adjustments, what they talked about, maybe it was just a little inspirational speech. Who knows? But looks like they're ready to go.
Wait, set, 380.
Touchdown defense. Check 24. Check 24.
Hey, Alabama.
On second and 11 now. Brady. It's a short one here. Complete to the tight end. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there were more people there to get him down.
They'll try and run for it with Jones. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 15 yards as Tampa Bay picks up the first.
Now, this is an example of breaking down a defense because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
Wait,
After the run by Jones, here's first and 10.
Pick it up, guys. Pick it up.
Brady going to throw. Throws right side, and that's complete. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
I've got to make sure that I don't take Tom Brady's greatness for granted, that we make it routine. How about that throw right there?
Yeah.
Another great completion.
And you know one area where he honed his throwing? He was a catcher in high school. He was actually drafted by the Expos in 1995 in the 18th round.
Wow, that would have been something to see him behind the dish.
Think he gunned down a few guys?
Gunned down a few guys trying to steal second. That would have been fun to watch.
Into the red zone, it's Brady. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
We've seen good cover skills on display throughout this game, really from both teams. And there's another nice example there of them making it difficult to complete a pass.
Brady's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10.
Watch tight end. Even. Four down. Even.
To throw again. Brady. Quick hitter here. It's complete. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
Out of the huddle now for play number 9 on this drive. This is third down and 8. Here's Hogan Bowale. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up fourth down. Defense simply not fooled by the draw there.
Well, they were thinking run to begin with, and what they tell their defensive linemen is, play the run on your way to the quarterback. If someone shows, go get him, and that's exactly what they did.
So out comes a field goal team now for the second time here today.
A 32-yard attempt.
Gay's kick is good. And the lead stretches to 6 here. It's 13-7. Well, looking at it from a defensive perspective, that keeps the deficit very, very manageable. You know, all things considered, not a bad job on the defensive side.
I would say that you've pointed out something pretty good right there, and that is you actually have both sides happy with that exchange. You know, happy in quotes, of course. One team, hey, we've kept it within range. The other side saying, hey, we put points on the board and did stretch out the lead. Let's see how this one turns out.
Yeah, still bottom line, though, 3 points for the opening drive of the third quarter. The punter, Pinion, now to kick this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line.
Let's go.
Now the attention turns back to the Rams offense as they get ready for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, just something to get you off to a quick start.
To throw is gone. Gets this into the hands of the tight end, Higbee. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Let's just break this down and make it pretty simple. Key to the drag route, letting the play develop, finding the hole in the defense, and giving your athlete, yes, athlete, a chance to make something happen once he has the ball in his hands.
So second and inches after that first down completion went just shy of the marker. They go play action with Gurley. Now Goff. And that's complete to Cooks. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. 28 yards the gain there on the catch and run. Third quarter of action. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. So for Buccaneer territory now, it's first and 10 at the 39-yard line. Here's Goff. And that one's complete to Gurley. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 16 yards is the pickup there, and a first down for L.A.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Cut. 180.
I got one. 45.
Mike. On first down, gone. And he's going to be taken down.
And plays like that really hurt play calling. They had a really nice gain on the previous play, but gave about half the yardage back on the sack. Excellent pressure up front. Nowhere to go with the football. Down he goes.
So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. Now Goff. Open man, Higbee, the tight end. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
Goff in the offense with a first and 10, and he's 4 for 4 now, throwing the ball to start the drive. Goff going to hand it to Gurley. And he'll get about 4 there as he takes it from the 10 down to the 6.
Well, it's been the air game that's taken them down on this drive before they finally turned around and handed it off on the last play.
And now they're looking for the big boys to get him in the end zone. Couldn't do it there.
It'll be interesting to see. Offensive lines had to pass block a lot on this drive. Will they be able to revert and fire out and create some space in the run game?
They'll stick to the ground game with Gurley. And he's going to take this one in for a Rams touchdown. A 6-yard touchdown run as his guys are an extra point away now from taking the lead here in the fourth.
I know the play ends up in the end zone with one person carrying the ball, but how about that big mass of humanity that guided him to that spot?
Yeah, they got there, but I love the dive. Always a fan of the dive. A very important extra point there, up and good. And they have taken the lead here in this fourth quarter. So that drive 7 plays in length. And last year's rushing and total touchdown leader, Todd Gurley, caps it with his first of the game here.
Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So out come the Bucks now. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them wanted to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick other than the extra point.
Watch
That's
tight,
it.
Tight end right.
Throwing on first down is Brady. He completes it to Evans. And he's upended after a gain of two out to the 27. Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and eight. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means they have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Play action. Now it's Brady. He's going deep for Brown. It's caught inside the 25. And he finally goes down, but not before reaching the 21. So from Rams territory now, it's first and 10, all the way down at the 21-yard line. So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you back. They've got a first down in field goal range already. And they'll try the jet sweep here. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play there. Second down.
Partner, you've got about 20 coaches on your payroll, but there's 60,000 of them in the stands. I don't think any of them like that play.
And the later we go, it's starting to sound like 100,000 in here. Brady's saying let's go as he'll hustle him to the line. Now Brady. Looking for Perriman there. He's got him. The Bucs passing game looking good on this drive. It's a first down. That's what they need right now. Get the first down, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
Just playing smart football, understanding the situation, making the plays necessary, and making sure that clock stops at every opportunity.
Question now, how do they want to work the clock here on first and goal? A field goal would give them the late lead. Here's Barber. And he's in. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Taking it in for 2 yards out. And the Bucs are going to retake the lead.
Wow, I know it's a never-say-never situation. But to me, that looks like that's the one that's going to finish them off.
The score that puts them in front here late, but now you got to rally your kick team, don't you, and say the last thing we need is a big return.
And what happens is guys get overeager, get out of their lane because they're so excited they want to make the last tackle. You mess up, could come back at you a long way.
So a big play coming now for the Bucs as they'll go for two. They're going to try and run. And he is not going to make it. So they won't be able to move this lead up to a touchdown as it'll remain a five-point ball game.
Well, partner, since this new two-point rule came into play, offense has spent a lot more time working on it. That means the defenses are doing the exact same thing.
And following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. This fielded at the two. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line. So Goff and the Rams down by five. A little over 80 ticks to go. They need a touchdown. A field goal is worthless now as they come up on first and 10. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33.
We want it. Come to my world.
They'll try and start the drive with Gurley. And they're going to get him behind the line yet again as his nightmare afternoon continues. Tackle made that time by Vita Vea.
I know a lot of people won't like the draw called in that situation, but every now and then that pops big. In this case, it didn't happen.
Counting down toward a minute to go in this football game. Back to throw. He gets it to Cooks. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Good work after the catch. Gets him 15 and a first down.
Okay, there's three timeouts left, right?
Think you got to use one here, don't you?
No doubt about it. I'd use one right here.
First down now, but the clock continues to move. Goff. Looking left sideline, incomplete. He was looking for Todd Gurley. That'll bring up second down. So he's unable to complete it there, and just not the game that you would expect from him. He's been off the mark, really, start to finish.
Yeah, it makes you wonder what exactly is going on. Is he a little bit dinged up here? Or is he just off just by a bit? Maybe he can get it back in this situation. He'll need to.
They'll look to throw. And his throw is incomplete. He was looking for Cooper Kupp there. And that'll make it third down. Couple extra defensive backs out there in the dime. And because of that, really not many places to throw the football, if any.
And typically, what would you want to do against that dime?
Run the football.
You want to run the ball, but you can't do it in this situation. Not nearly enough time on the clock. You having to really navigate against a tough defense presented against you.
Now it's gone. They got a man. It's Woods. The Rams going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in the game. Signal for a timeout, their second, as he'll stop it with 11 seconds remaining in the ball game. And the job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's second and 20.
Mike, 45. Stay with
him. He's back to throw. And he's got the hook up here. It's Woods. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. A big gain there after going backwards, and that'll lead to a third down. This will be play number seven on the drive. Third and a yard. Goff now to throw. And he's got it. It's caught for a touchdown. And they have taken the lead here in the final seconds.
So for those of little faith, guess what? It got done. They now have the lead with that touchdown this late in the contest. I wonder if that was a play they were holding or a play that they just knew would work from past experience.
Well, I just saw it in their eyes on the sideline before starting that last drive, and they did. You're right. They got it done. Looks like they're going to be the winners.
Now Zuerlein on to add the extra point. And the lead is now two. So that drive in total, eight plays. And it winds up with a touchdown for Los Angeles. Touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. This one taken from the seven.
Come on now, let's go!
Well, going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular affair.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took us down to the last play. We're still, you're wondering, could it happen? Possibly, even though we both knew it was a long shot.
So that'll do it for my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. With that, we say so long from Tampa.